You're watching 8-Bit Days a Week, and we're gonna play at least something everyone knows, familiar with at least, Final Fantasy VII on the PlayStation Classic. One of the multi-disc games there. So, the open button on the console will see some actual use. And I guess there's nothing really needed to be said about this game. Everyone knows it. Everyone probably played it. It's not actually my favorite Final Fantasy. That would happen to be Final Fantasy before this, which is 6, the one on the SNES. This one, actually, I know it's an unpopular opinion, but I really didn't like the story that much. But for a time, it was really groundbreaking, I guess. I do recall this was originally planned for the N64, but since it's kind of large in scope, they had to move it to the PlayStation, given that a CD can hold much more data. I wonder which Aerith name are we gonna get? Aerith or Aeris? I do like the spin-off though, the one on the PSP where you play as Zack. I'm actually more interested in that. It's just, tragically, his story ended there. And I'm glad he made even just a short appearance in the Advent Children movie. That is, if you watched the other version. I think the earlier version of Advent Children didn't have Zack's cameo where he speaks to Cloud about defeating Sephiroth. And all right, the joys of playing it not on a CD. Loading times are a lot faster. From what I know, there's supposed to be a remake going on. It's been going on for quite a while. Never seemed to. I mean, Square doesn't seem to have it released. They went through a lot of revisions, and until today, it's still not done. here's a little bit of history about my playing this game. Once again, I didn't play this on the PS1 during its time. I actually played the PC port. And yes, there was a PC port. It was sometime, I think it was around 1999 that they released a PC port of this. I don't know if it's 1998 or 1999. And as you'd expect, it had higher resolution than the PS1 version. The sound is definitely better on the PC version. And then I replayed this game on the PSP when it had its Steam release, re-release. Yeah, I haven't tried it actually. I think I played it enough, so to speak. I did try the PS1 version sometime just a few years ago. That was around when the PS3. I can't really recall which year was it. So yeah, I probably played. I've run through the game maybe two or three times. Three or four times here. Among the PlayStation Final Fantasy games, there's actually quite a lot. That's 7, 8, 9. There's Tactics, and they actually re-released 4, 5, and 6, which were terrible ports, actually. The one I enjoyed the most was 9. 9 is the best. Of course, among the three main titles that was on the PS1, 7, 8, 9. So 9 is my favorite, followed by this one, and then 8. 8 was just terrible. It has its moments, but overall, it's probably one of the reasons why I began starting to dislike RPGs. When the new version of this does come out, I am interested on playing that, of course. But I suspect it's gonna be quite a while. In fact, I won't be surprised if they delayed it again and be released on the whatever next generation would be, like a PS5 or something. But for now, I think this is okay, playing it on the PlayStation Classic. That's enough to tide us all over, for me at least. And nothing more to be said there, this is definitely a worthy inclusion. I'm pretty sure if this wasn't included, the riots would be louder on why this game or that game wasn't included. In fact, if you don't have like an existing PlayStation console, this kinda makes the Classic at least okay to buy. Although some might argue, you know, just get a PS1 original. But I hate dealing with CDs nowadays. They really just tend to easily not work with a few scratches that could halt your progress entirely. Another option would be, I guess, to buy a Vita TV, a PS TV, and I think you can download and play this there. So you get your HD option, you get the game without having to deal with CDs. Or get the Steam version. I think that has a little extras that help it, to be more up to date, modern, so to speak, and to eliminate some of the more tedious aspects of this game. But I think, like the gamers today, they might find this kinda underwhelming already. It isn't what it used, like what it's used to be before. Everything here, when it was released at its time, felt really grand. Like it was really a big thing, but nowadays, those are pretty much standard stuff. so they might be underwhelmed. Ish. But I suppose that's really up to the gamer. You can still find some fun in this one. If the graphics, it may have like aged poorly, but it's by no means unplayable. It's not like a blurry mess or something. Actually, it is a blurry mess. But the keyword is still playable. Hey. Anyway, I think that should be it for the Final Fantasy VII here in this video. I'm gonna continue playing this soon. Upload it. Stream it maybe. We'll see. But anyway, you are watching 8-Bit Days a Week. Please leave a comment, hit the like and subscribe. And thanks for watching.